Florida, and I'm so happy to see you, and this is a crazy morning. A lot of sunshine, a lot to do, and, well, I want to start you off with showing you my orange juice. So this is how much I make every day, just for the start. Two big, big jars, and then I have also some later with grapefruit in it. Amazing. I never tire. It tells me something. My body loves it. I love it. Taste. So I wanted to come to talk to you today. I'm talking to you that has pain, that doesn't feel, you know, in great health. Maybe you have been diagnosed with something. Maybe you just have migraines. Maybe you have constantly urinary tract infections. Maybe you have low energy. And if you are in pain, then what I do is I look at your story. Now that's interesting, because I'm not a doctor and I might look at things a little different, but I look at things from a health perspective. I am looking at why you're not thriving, why you're not in optimal health. So you come to me and you tell me that you have these, you know, concerns. It might be serious, it might not be that serious, but it's restricting you from living that glorious life that you're supposed to live. I look at your story, and what I see is a whole set of symptoms that goes together like hand in a glove. Believe me. I was talking to several people yesterday, and it always amazes me. Every time, when I see a client that comes to me with all these symptoms, so they're telling me everything from having bad sleep, or weight gain, or it could be diabetes. Everything goes together with the system in the body. So a symptom is always just the body telling you a story, telling you where it is congested, telling you where it's gotten weak and sick and not thriving anymore from abuse and from the genes that you got handed down. So when I look at that, I see you. I see your life. I see what you've lived, and I see what you live. And together with, you see, a story is not only the symptoms and physical. See, that's where we go wrong. You go to a doctor or someone, and you tell them that you have a bad arm. Well, you might be holding on to something that's work-related, that is related to your relationships, on top of your bad, badass diet, you know? So I look at the whole and I see the person that has been living your life, getting you to exactly where you are today. Exactly. Naturally. It's obvious. Like there's no mystery around it. You didn't get anything by chance, you see. We create everything. You didn't just fall ill unless you were, you know, bit by a snake or the truck hit you. I mean, that's different. I'm talking, we're creating every pain that we have from what we've been living. That is good news. So when I talk to you and I see you like that, I can explain to you why that story is still in your body. Because obviously, we don't want to live that. But our want becomes so big that all we want, see, again, the word want. All we seek is relief, right? So we're used to going after that pill, which will never work. We think it might work for a minute, but, you know, it never really will. I would have been dead. But the story is that your story is something that you own. And most often we go around owning it by speaking it. Telling people around us what we have and what we haven't, and you know, we join different groups of people that has the same type of ailments, and then we can talk about it instead of addressing what's really going on. And when I look in your eyes, when I get your eyes pictures that I love to read, I never see that it doesn't go together with your story. Meaning, when I look at a pair of eyes and I look at your story, what's going on with your health, in your body, what's really going on, they fit together perfectly. And what I see usually is congestion, congestion, congestion. Full of crap and shit, parasites, mucus, the acids. And acids, you know, you've heard people talk about acids. That's just the term that we use for everything that's on the acid side. It was breaking down the cell. That's all. Parasites are on the acid side. Chemicals are on the acid side. Acidic food, meaning dairy, for example, which is crazy mucus forming. You were told when you were little that, well, not even when you were little, maybe even today you believe that dairy is good for you. It is crazy mucus forming, and it is so acidic to the body. It's literally coating your intestines. It's coating your small intestines, which is where you have your villi, where you are absorbing all your nutrients. So when I look in your eyes, I can see, you see, where your bowels are located in your eyes. I can see the weaknesses in your different organs and your glands. I can see where your thyroid is. I can see where your heart is and your lungs are. And I can see if there is a weakness there. I can see if there's a lot of lymph, if there's sulfur. I can see that you're congested. And I have never, ever met a person yet that had any form of pain or not optimal health that was not congested. So it really is the same thing, you see. Which makes it easy, but it makes it hard in terms that we have to rethink the whole health paradigm. This is a new paradigm. We have a body that's an alchemist. We have a body that is functioning optimally, all by itself, always, day and night. The only thing is, we're not letting it. We are numbing it, dumbing it, abusing it. We are abusers of our own body. Now think about that. Being a human on this earth is about being in the human body. Now, I don't know what you believe or not believe, or what your, you know, perception of your world is, but this remains. You are in the physical body. And it doesn't matter how much you work on your spiritual being, because being in this body is still a huge part of your experience here. And there is a reason that emotions even get stuck and show symptoms in this physical body. There is a reason that just being outside, walking barefoot on Mother Earth, has a reaction in the human body. This is how close to nature we are. And by drinking milk from a cow, that's not natural. I told someone yesterday, could you imagine just laying down on the ground, sucking on the cow? And you know, most of us couldn't even imagine that. We can't imagine that. We can't imagine killing an animal with our bare hands either, eating it. Why? Because we are compassionate beings. We thrive by caring for. We're nurturers. We're emotionally connected to all life. And it is not in our nature to kill to eat. That's one part of it. The other part is, if you eat any type of meat, remember this, it putrefies in your body. It has no fiber. You don't have the digestion to digest it. You don't have the stomach acid. Carnivore has a very, very short intestine. The meat is supposed to go in and out very quickly. We're fruit eaters. We can have some vegetables, some leafy greens, sure, but we're fruit eaters. And there's a lot of resistance around that. And I can look at your story and your health and your eyes and tell you how far we have come from that natural path. And that is no kidding. Because we see how sick we are, right? So this is to you. This is to you that are in pain right now. Your health can easily be read and understood by just looking at your story, what you have lived, all of your symptoms. They're leading back to the same thing, you see, a stagnant lymphatic system. Did you know that we had 2 times more lymph in our body than blood? Not many people talk about that. Dr. Morse talks about it a lot, but not many people talk about that. And when you really understand the simplicity, it makes a lot of sense. The only thing is, what are we going to do with everything that we learned? I see a lot of people having that as the largest obstacle to health. Not doing what you're supposed to do, but that, because that's not much. That's just eating clean food from nature. The hard part is letting go of all the questions and everything that's holding you back from choosing such an easy path. Our intellect has gotten in our way big time. We've gotten so smart, we're screaming for science. Do you have any scientific proof that this will work? No. And you know what? You're never going to find it. There is no scientific proof. To me, science is simply doing, observing, experiencing, and learning from it. That's science. There is no science in nature, in the term, you know, in the way that we're looking for it. Big Pharma is not going to produce papers that is going to satisfy your intellect. And that is medical talking, that we're looking for proof. I challenge you. I mean, only 1 week of fruits only will make your body different. Something will happen, depending on where you are, depending on how much shit you're in, you know, you have in your body. You'll experience something, I promise you. And in my membership site, I have first week of May coming up. We're going to do an all-fruit challenge. And I'm going to be there every day. I'm going to hold your hand. I'm going to answer all the questions. I'm going to have so much fun. You know, and what's not to like? That's what I'm saying. You know, it's so good. It's just food. Would you not rather be crazy, healthy, and happy and eat amazing food than to hold on to something that's keeping you sick and tired? I know I would. I know I did, right? I did. And that's why I'm so enthusiastic about this, even on a Saturday morning, even before I have my juice, because I just needed to say that it was this yesterday. I had many amazing clients and the stories they tell. And what I see from that, and the beauty of the healing, the path that they're you know, undertaking, it's amazing. So just you wait. I tell you, this is the winning team. You better get on this winning team, because we're never going to stop. We're going to keep on going, because we're going towards health. We're not doing any disease discussions at all. So you can't, you know, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what they call it. We know what they call it. It doesn't matter what you think you have. Or you think you haven't. It doesn't matter. Health is health. I always said that. I always said, when I was at my sickest and I was just laying there, I had so many strange symptoms. You know, you couldn't go after one symptom. All I thought of was, if I build health, then there can be no illness, right? If I just focus on building health. So always focus on what it is that you do want, not what you don't want. So keep your focus on where you're going. Don't look back at, you know, going that way. And that's another big thing. you know, when you fall off, and I'm going to come back later and I'm going to talk about cravings, but that's a big, huge topic. The cravings, addictions, the parasites. But the thing is, if you keep your focus on what you're doing and why you're doing it, there is no reason to look back. There is no reason to look around for solutions anymore. Because you are it. You are the solution. You are worthy. You know, it's a big thing. You are worthy. And there is no reason not to get healthy. There is no reason. I mean, I think most people can think of many reasons on the top of their head that they could use. Never going to be good enough, you know, because you're worth it. So that's it. I don't want to take too much of your time. But this was a short, I just wanted to drop by this morning from sunny Florida before I go outside, take my juice on the deck and enjoy some sunshine. And, you know, I want to tell you how I work and how this works. And it's easy. I read your story. I see you. You know, and we got this. So, have a blessed new week after this weekend. And we'll talk soon. And I'm going to get up now and I'm going to turn off this video. And by doing so, I say namaste to you, dear self. I love you all.